Welcome to online worship at Living Lord. We are so glad that you joined us today. We invite you to check out our website, livinglord.org, and also to share, like, and subscribe to this Facebook or YouTube video. Today, I would like to speak about how to find love during a turbulent time. Now, we live in turbulent times in many ways, but that is exactly why Jesus' words can mean so much to us, because he did as well. I will be sharing a passage from the Gospel of John, the 14th chapter, but it is from the time when he is with his disciples and getting ready for his arrest later that evening. And his disciples remind me of a hockey game that I saw when I was serving a congregation in Dubuque. The minor league hockey team was called the Fighting Saints, and it was an exciting game, and they came from behind to win. However, it reminds me of the disciples. They were fighting saints too, always jockeying for position and squabbling with each other. But Jesus gives them a promise that allows them to come from behind and win as well. From John 14, Jesus says that he promises that his love will always be with them. What's more, he promises that his Father's love will always be with them, and furthermore, that he will send an advocate, the Holy Spirit, to always be with them. So right there in the middle of life, of a turbulent time, Jesus points us to love. Now, our ideas about love may be different than Jesus. There was a teacher who once asked in a class, "Johnny, what is the difference between like and love?" And he responded, "I like my parents, but I love cheeseburgers." We sometimes think of love as a strong preference or an emotional attachment to something, but what Jesus is speaking about is so much more than that. He starts with God's love, the love that seeks the very best for another person, that has an unlimited capacity for love and to be shared. You know, last week we heard Lewis talk about how the love of his mother reflects to him the love of God. And that reminds me of a man named Frederick Borsch. He was a professor at our Lutheran seminary in Philadelphia, and he and his wife had a baby boy that they named Benjamin. And Frederick Borsch loved his firstborn son. He had never had a brother, and so he found that he just poured out all of his love to his son and thought that this was the best thing for his life imaginable. Then a few years later, he and his wife learned that they were expecting another child. And Frederick was honestly worried. He thought that if they had another baby, he would have to divide his love between the two of them, and each would get less. And he was worried that the second child would feel slighted because he already had such a deep love for his firstborn son. He thought of love as a pie, and the more people that share the pie, the smaller the slices will be. Then, surprise, he and his wife had twins. But the bigger surprise was what he discovered inside of himself, that his love for any of the three children did not shrink because he shared it, but there was more and more to spare. The slices of love did not get smaller, they grew. And he said it was a strange new arithmetic. The pie seemed to get larger. That is how God's love is. It's enormous, it's limitless. It's growing. It is infinite. And so we love because God first loved us. And God's love pours out into our lives, and then we develop the capacity to love others. We love when we know ourselves to be loved. Yet, admittedly, in our human hands, love can feel limited and fragile. It can be driven out by fear or pride or hatred. I had a very good friend, a colleague who, when we were young pastors and young fathers and young men, hung out together a lot and developed a deep friendship. On every one of our days off in the winter, we would go cross-country skiing together. Well, as time went on, we ended up moving to new calls in different places. We said a few things that we probably should not have said, and perhaps we were too much alike. And so we drifted apart as time went on until there was an occasion when we were reunited again. And we discovered that the love that we had for each other had not diminished, but we were able to renew our friendship. We were grateful that we let go of whatever had come between us. And that's my word to you. Let go of what comes between you and others and grab a hold of the love that God intends for you. Be open to love. Jesus' words are as much an invitation as a commandment, an invitation to turn things around and live by love. Love can do that for us. A man named Bill Farrell was a soldier in the Vietnam War, and he had a tragic accident in which an explosion tore off both of his legs. And for several years, he went on a binge of hatred and bitterness and destructive behavior. He finally settled down on the family farm in Whitewater, Wisconsin. And there his pastor came one day and said, "Bill, will you take in a Vietnamese refugee family who fled to this country?" And at first Bill wanted to say no, but then he changed his mind and accepted them. However, he treated them like slaves and expected them to wait on him hand and foot and to do the most grueling farm work. Nevertheless, they repaid his hatred with kindness. And so they would give him birthday cards and Christmas cards and gifts and show him the love that he was unable to show to them. Well, eventually that family left for a more permanent settlement in this country, and then he got another family and he did the same thing. And they repaid his hatred with kindness as well. And on it went, family after family, until one day in 1979, he had received a whole pile of birthday cards and gifts from all of these Vietnamese families that he had helped. And as he looked at it, the anger melted away in tears as he was allowing himself to feel love for these people that had shown him so much love. He continued helping refugee families, and then one day he learned about the poverty and the need for medical care back in Vietnam. So he went to a number of medical supply companies, and he got donations of medicines and other supplies, and then he personally delivered them to Vietnam, to the people that needed them most. And in one momentous event, Bill Farrell, the veteran from the United States, met 200 veterans who were like him, but they were Vietnamese, so they fought on the other side of the war. And all of them had lost limbs or had been paralyzed in the fighting. And his anger was transformed into love finally. Love can change us, and it means seeing things through another person's perspective and sometimes through their pain. One of the best pieces of advice that I learned years ago was that hatred is the wounded side of love. Very often when we love something so very much and it goes bad, our love can turn into hatred as a result of that. And so what we need to do is to ask, when we feel hatred, when we see hatred, where is the pain? What is underneath all of that hurt? And then pray that your hatred may be transformed into love again through the healing power of God's love, so that your love may be restored. At the beginning of this message, I told a little story about my time serving a congregation in Dubuque, Iowa. During that year, there were several cross burnings in racially mixed neighborhoods, and the suspicion was that there were some people that were imitating the Ku Klux Klan and trying to scare away the African Americans who lived in those neighborhoods. They never found the perpetrators, but several congregations in that city started publicizing the phrase, "Choose love over fear." As Martin Luther King Jr. said, "Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hatred cannot drive out hatred. Only love can do that." So today Jesus speaks to you and to me about love, how to find love in turbulent times, the unlimited love that God has for us in Jesus Christ, flowing out into our lives, driving out hatred, and allowing us to choose daily love over fear. May you feel that love of God today, every day this week, and every year of your life, and throughout all eternity. Amen.
Living together into the promise of God's love, together let us pray for the world, the church, and all those who are in need. Abiding God, you have revealed yourself to us in the form of your Son, Jesus Christ. Embolden your church as your followers to reveal your love to everyone in our speaking and in our living. Your commands are good and merciful. Give us courage to take hold of our baptismal promises, to work for justice, advocate for the voiceless, and free the oppressed and imprisoned in body, mind, or spirit. We hold up in our prayers this week Betty and Fred, Ed and Nancy, Dennis, Melba, John, Addie, and the Leisman family, and be with those families who are suffering or continue to suffer from economic hardships. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care through Christ our Lord. And together we pray as Jesus taught.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again after supper, he took the cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me."
So we thank you for the wine and for the bread. For we see the life you gave and the blood you shed. And we remember your wondrous love. You gave your body, you shed your blood. And we remember your wondrous love.
In whatever turbulence you find yourself in, may the love of God in Jesus Christ fill your life today and always. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
One goes out to the world changer, shining your light in the face of danger. Tell us what you know. You're a saint, you're a son, you're a promise keeper. Bottom of the well, still digging down deeper. How far you gonna go? Chasing down hope, moving on dreams, taking that path. Maybe it'll lead you home, maybe it won't. Nobody knows why your heart is broken. Nobody cries while your prayers are going on. But love does. Nobody walks on the road you're paving. Nobody sees all the souls you're saving. Nobody walks on the road you're paving. nobody sees all soldiers saving. Somebody sees, somebody knows.